we want to see the future processes, not only for the person, processes sariya lekapothe countries desham kuda doctor daggara vellalsi untundi. Morning chusina slide idi, once again I am repeating it. If you see, we were so strong in our GDP contribution. So many years. But later, we dived a lot, just falling. In my feeling, or I believe strongly in that, is we really not adapted the right processes or processes. Because what is true today will not be true tomorrow, or what was true yesterday definitely will become false today. So this change, we have not adapted, mana adapt chesukoledu, so we could not catch it. Even in that slide, we missed the industrial revolution also. One of the thing where we would have taken it, so we missed it completely, the industrial revolution also. So this puts a question to me. Same 24 hours for everyone. See, maniki 24 hours lokate Japanese ki or Americans or Germans, every country andaruki 24 hours lokate. Everybody goes every in the morning, they go for a work, they do the work. But what is the difference? Some countries, they have been growing, they have been sustaining, they have been producing a lot, while the quality of life chala improving. But for us, where the things are really lying. So the constant reason is changes. We are failing to embrace the changes, adapt to the new systems. But every change brings threatened opportunity. Oka change vachindi anukondi, threat vastundi as well as opportunity kuda untundi. Equally it puts in front of us. Rendu mundu manu mundu threat and opportunity equal gane vastundi anamata. So this really puts us a challenge. Manaki mundu oka challenge em avutundante, to overcome or to take the opportunity, we must be in a position to adapt to the new threats. We must be in a position to change to new processes. So this is the, the future. I mean, from the morning, people are telling so many kind of things, revolutions, connectivities and all. See, they are trying to even project farther and farther. I mean, even space colonization, like, people are trying to predict what the future is going to be. So such a the projection into the future, they are going like anything, even money 2.0, transport 2.0, like that, they are predicting. So the changes are going to be exponential and faster. So how do we really take the process to suit to the these technologies which have been discussed, being discussed from the morning? So exponential changes. Mark anedi edo slow ga jaragatledu actually. In fact, technology changes chuste, my generation or even the senior generation, they would have seen. Nenaithe even the music reproduction record ela undante, just with a mechanical thing, if you wind it, it will rotate. Oka chinna needle tho oka gramophone laga untundi, gramophone adi kuda nenu experience chusanu. Then lot of technology is there. The idea is producing the music. Oka music ni mana elaga reproduce chestunnam ane process lo chala changes vachestundi. So idi chala oka generation lone nearly 3 or 4 or 5 types of technology ni mana chudalsi vachestundi. So this changes is happening faster and faster. Embrace changes, adapt to the new environment, understanding the world as a system of systems. So this system of systems really throws a great challenge in front of us. సిస్టమ్ ఆఫ్ సిస్టమ్స్కి క్లాసికల్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఏది తీసుకోవచ్చు అంటే మన ట్రాఫిక్ సిస్టమ్. బిగ్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిస్టంలో నేను ఒక సిస్టమ్, మన వెహికల్ ఒక సిస్టమ్, అలాగా ఆల్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ పీపుల్ ఆఫ్ సిస్టమ్, ట్రాఫిక్ కంట్రోల్స్ ఇస్ అ సిస్టమ్. సో ఇలాగ స్మాల్ స్మాల్ సిస్టమ్స్ అంతా కలిపినప్పుడు ఇట్ బికమ్స్ అ బిగ్ సిస్టమ్ ఆఫ్ సిస్టమ్స్. ఇఫ్ యూ క్యాట్ఫుల్లీ అబ్జర్వ్ అవర్ సిస్టమ్ ఆఫ్ సిస్టమ్స్, డూ యూ థింక్ ఇస్ ఇట్ ఎఫెక్టివ్గా ఉందనుకుంటున్నారా? సో మన ట్రాఫిక్ మీరు అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తే ఎవ్రీబడి విల్ కంపీట్, ఎవ్రీబడి విల్ కంపీట్. వన్ మోర్ అబ్జర్వేషన్ ఇస్ లైక్ దట్. సో వెన్ యూ క్రాస్ ద జంక్షన్, ఈవెన్ యూ కెన్ ఆల్సో అబ్జర్వ్ అనమాట. వెన్ ద జంక్షన్స్ ఆర్ వేర్ నార్మలీ వాట్ ఐ మీన్ వెన్ యూఆర్ డ్రైవింగ్ వాట్ యూఆర్ సపోజ్ టు డూ యాజ్ అ ప్రాసెస్ కింద చూస్తే, జంక్షన్ దగ్గర చాలా క్రాసింగ్ క్రిస్ క్రాసింగ్స్ ఉంటుంది, పీపుల్ హావ్ టు క్రాస్ కేర్ఫుల్లీ, ఇట్స్ అ రిస్కీ థింగ్, ఎనీ యూ హ్యావ్ అ కొల్లిషన్ అండ్ ఆల్. బట్ వెన్ యూ సీ అవర్ పీపుల్ విల్ మూవ్ ఫాస్టర్ ఇన్ ద జంక్షన్ అండ్ రోడ్ వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ సో ఫ్రీ, దే విల్ బి గోయింగ్ స్లో. ఫస్ట్ టైం ఐ అబ్జర్వ్ ఇట్ మేబీ యాక్సిడెంట్ అనుకోని, ఐ బీన్ అబ్జర్వింగ్ దిస్ నియర్లీ 3 to 4 years. ఈవెన్ ఐ ఎంక్వైర్డ్ విత్ ఆల్ మై ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఆల్సో అట్ ద జంక్షన్ పీపుల్ విల్ రైజన్ ఫాస్టర్. ఓకే, దేన్ ఫస్ట్ టైం ఐ థాట్ ఓకే దిస్ గైస్ హావింగ్ సమ్ అర్జెన్సీ, చాలా అర్జెంటుగా వెళ్ళిపోవాలేమో అనుకుని క్రాస్ అయిన తర్వాత కొంచెం దూరం తిరిగి వెళ్తే ఉంటాయి, అతను చాలా చాలా స్లోగా వెళ్తున్నారు అనమాట. ఇఫ్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ ఎ రియల్ అర్జెన్సీ రష్, వేర్ దర్ ఇస్ అ రోడ్ ఇస్ గో సో ఫ్రీ, హ్యూడ్ హ్యావ్ రష్. సో ద సిస్టమ్ ఆఫ్ సిస్టమ్ వేర్ పీపుల్ క్యాన్ అడ్జస్ట్ అండ్ గివ్ బెటర్ సేఫ్టీ, దేర్ వీ డు నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఎన్ అడ్జస్ట్మెంట్. We do not, suppose okkalu velthunnarante just okka few seconds mana aithe iddaru velipovachu, but what happens, people they come together and jam and time is lost in that. So the process, because what we are seeing outside the world, that's going to get embedded in our system. So the processes need to start from the external world. So the future is arriving faster than most of the people think. So we have been seeing how the future is going to be, but it is going to be arriving faster. That is the rhythm. So the one action or one rhythm, one pulse to other pulse, it's going to be more and more with the technology. Then when technology changes, all the business also getting changed. So one has to, we have to adapt to the rhythm. If we miss the rhythm, then we will lose. So the system thinking is the way of understanding how things influence one another in a whole. The same classic example of traffic. How do we influence? Sometimes koni koni accident meeru try to find the root cause, somebody would have slightly created a small trouble that would have created another trouble to another person, then another trouble, finally somebody will meet the accident. So they are all connected. So a mistake, by the time this accident happens, the person would have moved away from the scene. So the systems are so knitted and connected. So they influence each other. And with the IoT and all these kind of penetrating technologies, even in the morning keynote, our guest speaker also given connectivity of the different countries. So the connections are becoming closer and closer. So the systems are becoming complex. Everything is getting connected more. So an organization is a system. A nation is also a system. And the process helps you to run the system most effectively. So we have systems. We are processing the system. But process is very much required to run the system most efficiently. So whether we have a process or not, by way of our traffic, what do you say? Agree or don't agree? You agree? I think you have become a part of the system. For accustomed to the system, for adapted to the system. really, if you really take the data and try to analyze it, then definitely we will agree upon it. That definitely will happen also. So this is a system of system. Things are getting connected or knitted. So most companies have good people. So I mean, Peter Drucker is one of the management guru. He says most companies have good people. The companies that we know long term have best processes. So it says the people are not so important, the processes are so important. This is, he stresses upon the process than the people. So how effectively we run the process decides about the life of a company, or how the company can take different shapes or different models it can adapt based on the technology disruptions or changes in various things, it can take the shape. What is this process? Everybody is saying process. You look into the process, see the process. A process is a set of activities that interact to achieve a result. You do every day, you have a lot of process. You will be doing not many processes. You will be making some activities every day, morning, day in and day out. But only the problem is the view. How do you see with a viewpoint of the process? So before going into the process, just you see this, we can manage world by dividing the people by our specialist skills and knowledge. Work by functional discipline. Earlier, see, some work is there, just you do this, we didn't say anything. Like whether you do this, and we can make. This is a functional approach of the management. So, process approach is completely different. We see what is the outcome. What is the outcome required? What is the object required? Where we are standing now? Or what is the starting point? What is the end point? What is the objective? So between these two, we will see what should happen. Yeh jaraga le ni chustam kari, yavar cheyali, adedi yehi. Manushulu meeda, we will not put any person onto this. We do not view it as a person dependent. So we see that what should happen. ఇది జరగడానికి ఏమేమి కావాలి, లైక్ విత్ ద స్కిల్స్, వాట్ సెట్ ఆఫ్ స్కిల్స్ ఎ పర్సన్ షుడ్ హ్యావ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్. వీ డు నాట్ నేమ్ ఎనీ పర్సన్. సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ద పర్సన్ ఈస్ నాట్ హ్యావింగ్ ద స్కిల్, లైక్ ఇన్ ఫ్యూచర్ వీ వాంట్ టు వర్క్ విత్ ఏఐ, మెషిన్ లెర్నింగ్, ఆల్ ద థింగ్స్ వీ వాంట్ టు వర్క్ టుమారో, దీస్ ప్రాసెసెస్ ఆర్ రిక్వైర్డ్ ఇన్ అవర్ సిస్టమ్. సో దీస్ స్కిల్స్ నీడ్ టు బి అడాప్టెడ్. వీ షుడ్ టేక్ దిస్ skill, we should learn this skill. So skill is put into the process. So always process need to be viewed as a process without having any dependency on any persons or anything influencing. So what is the object and outcome really? So from where you are standing and what is the outcome, how you are going to approach this without having any other influences. So outcome of every process, okay, you may decide that this is the process I'm going to do, I'll have stage one, step two, all that. But you need to have a touchstone to check the its value in the consumption chain. What is touchstone? You know this. 50% of our population is having a lot of influence on this. It's a touchstone. You check the goal, whether the goal is good or bad. So we take, design a process, take a value stone and push this and see this whether your process is giving some value or not. Because when the process is okay, you can have any steps. You can design a process with a, dividing the steps nicely, keeping all the things, but the process may not yield the value. So we need to go into the details. Finally, the value need to be calculated. So you need, we have different processes across the consumption chain. So right from the needs to all the stages. So we need to apply value and see the value onto the every processes we design in the entire consumption chain. So how to test any process on value customer? So we design the process, how do we really test it? How to make processes and check value creation? How do we really do this? So Edward Deming is one of the quality guru person. Deming ni chula US person kanna Japanese bar vaadunnaru. They have used Deming advice and they have improved their processes and they are so successful giving a quality product. So in God we trust, all others bring data. Means whomever tells something, so suppose if you say something, you need to say with the data. Only with the God we trust, remaining everyone should come with the data only. So that is what, everyone should come with the data, then only you can really make it. So the trust, to build the trust, morning we had this equation. So the data only can really make this equation a valid one. So value determined by data, not by assumptions. So we may think that, like today I'm starting from the office, I'm reaching my home, I may think that I'm reaching 5 minutes, or within 5 minutes, I may feel that I have reached 10 minutes. Unless otherwise I don't note timing and take the data, it only becomes my assumptions and belief, that's all. Really the data is not substantiated with this. But data is a scientific reality, the truth. So always a process need to capture the correct, I mean right amount of data to evaluate its value creation. So this is our own example. In the beginning we have been using this full board assembly. Like a person will take all the components and start building the entire PCB, and each component they will put it into the PCB and they populate the PCB, as a single person will be producing the single thing. So then later we have adapted the chain process. So this process, one PCB starts, so one few components have been inserted by a first person, next person does second stage, third stage, so it is incrementally going step by step, and finally the outcome of the PCB is arriving. So advantages of this, really there will be advantage, then we need to verify the data also, the measurement. So in terms of time per unit, so it has come to around 15. There it's defects, this is also very very important thing. So before it is ranging from this to that, and again the difference also less, even the overall quantity is also less here. So really whether our process is working or not is supported by this data. So with this data we know that we have improved and it has created a value in terms of time, again value in terms of reduction in the defects. So technology facilitates data enablement. So Bhavani Shankar, you were saying the IoT. So data, technology enablement, I mean data enablement, even now I have enabled the Google, so every day it is completely tracked. So if I go into see my timeline, so what is my average time traveling between my office and the house, everything is available. So even I can enable my movement with data. So all the processes invariably change to data-enabled processes. So with the facility, when the technology is enabling us, even the hardware prices are becoming very, very less. So IoT is going to go inside more and more into every project. So it's going to be all the data-enabled, every process can be made in a data-enabled process. So with the data, we try to see with analytics-driven digital dashboard and value added versus non-valid value added thing can be verified with this dashboard. So we have a dashboard, all the analytics are thrown onto the screen. So with this we can see what are the value additions are happening in this or is there anything is non-value added things are happening in this. So with this, again, we work with the change of process such that it eliminates all the non-value added activities and reaching to the value added activities. So this cycle can be repeated or spin around very, very faster. So where do we really stand? Because all the processes are moved by the people. So we design, we keep machines, we keep data points, all the things. But this is moved by the people. So where do you really stand? There are different kind of people, okay. So data denial. So you don't believe the data. So even if you give the data, people do not believe the data. And you don't care about the data, and you feel you do not need it. That's a data indifferent person. Data informed. So you use it only when it supports your opinion. Meeku edi correct anipistundo daniki saripoyina data matram teeskoni try to support this. But data driven is you use it to shape and inform all your decisions. Completely you may have to rethink and reorient. Suppose a data driven person, he completely takes all the data and he may really rework on his assumptions or on his idea, and everything he may change completely. He may take 180 degree shift also. Through data driven decision. So when I make a decision with the data, then all the value actions we can take. So all the value actions really adds some value or removes some non-value added activities and all. So, but only with the mass of data you cannot do it actually. So when you make all the data points in your process, if you take lot many data and simply keep it, it is not going to give you any result at all. But you have to use the data. So the knowledge is very, very important. Otherwise, simply we'll be drowning in the data. We may have big Excel, we may open Excel, we may show thousands of records on this. This is not there. But simply it's an information, unless otherwise we work on it and get some knowledge out of it and do some sort of value action, this becomes only an information, that's all. Technological disruptions. What it requires and needs agility. So, because you get a lot of data points, you get information, and you want to decide the value action. But you must be in a position to act quickly. This is very important. So what is this agility? So inclusive decision making. So morning also it's discussed. So knowledge will not be with only one person. So we have to have a inclusive decision making. So augmented decision making. So your decision should be supported, or it is supported with additional thing. It's augmented for you to take decisions. So we take decisions, informed decision making. Normal decision making becomes informed decision making. And fast execution. So we need to execute very, very faster. So here you have to see the dynamic. Agility means dynamic. So you need to have a dynamic resources. Today you have 2 people, tomorrow you must be in a position to take 50 people. Again, we may have to shrink to 10 people. Like that, we have to dynamically, we must be able to pull the resources, shrink the resources, all the things, we must be in a position to do it for the faster execution. Then behavior awareness and situational awareness. What's happening in terms of technology? So hyper awareness, it asks for a hyper awareness. So what is happening in terms of technology? How we can really can influence our current processes, all the things, and it must be able to act very, very quickly. So then again, the cost of poor quality should reach to zero. Cost of poor quality comes out of the mistakes what we do, like a reworks. If you design, if you make a PCB, rework. If you design and do something, some piece of code, and we found a lot of bugs, and again we have been corrected, it is also a rework, and the cost of poor quality is going to increase in that. So we need to reduce it. It should be zero. సమ్ ప్రాసెసెస్ షాల్ బికమ్ ఎ కల్చర్. యాక్చువల్గా ఇప్పుడు 5 ఇయర్స్ చేయమంటే చేస్తారు, అదే ఈరోజు ఎవరైనా వచ్చి 5 ఇయర్స్ ఆర్గనైజర్ వచ్చి యు డూ 5 ఇయర్స్ స్టార్ట్ 5 ఇయర్స్ అంటే చేయడం జరుగుతుంది. బట్ కల్చర్ అంటే ఇట్స్ అ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ లైఫ్, వీ డూ ఇట్ డైలీ. ఎవ్రీ డే యూ డూ బ్రషింగ్ వితౌట్ టెల్లింగ్ సమ్వన్ టెల్లింగ్ ఆర్ సమ్థింగ్, ఇట్ బికమ్స్ అ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ లైఫ్. యూ డూ ఇట్ వెదర్ సంబడి సేస్ ఆర్ సంబడి డు నాట్ సే ఇట్ ఆల్సో. సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద యాక్షన్స్ వీ డూ ఇట్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ, ఇట్ హస్ బికమ్ అ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ లైఫ్. సో దీస్ థింగ్స్ షుడ్ హ్యాపన్ యాజ్ అ కల్చర్. సపరేట్గా ఎవరు క్వాలిటీ నుంచో లేకపోతే వేరే వాళ్ళు ఎవరిని వచ్చి చెప్పి జరిగితే ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ ఇంప్రూవ్ అవర్ ప్రాసెసెస్ ఎఫెక్టివ్లీ. సో యూ కెన్ సీ దిస్, ఇఫ్ యూ కెన్ మిస్టేక్ ప్రూఫ్ ఇట్, ద కాస్ట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి వెరీ వెరీ లెస్, వీ లూజ్ వెరీ లెస్. బట్ వెన్ ఇట్ రీచెస్ టు ద కస్టమర్ విత్ ద మిస్టేక్, ద కాస్ట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి వెరీ వెరీ హై. సో వీ హ్యావ్ మేజర్ ప్రాసెసెస్ ఇన్ ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్, ఆర్ఎండ్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ కస్టమర్ సపోర్ట్ అండ్ బిజినెస్ సపోర్ట్. ఆర్ఎండ్ షుడ్ బి వర్కింగ్ విత్ ద ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ డిజైన్ థింకింగ్ అండ్ ఇన్స్టెంట్ పీఓసీ, లైక్ ఇన్స్టెంట్ కాఫీ ఆర్ ఇన్స్టెంట్ థింగ్. వీ మస్ట్ బి ఏబుల్ టు డూ ద పీఓసీ వెరీ క్విక్లీ. టుడే వీ థాట్, టుమారో వీ మస్ బి ఏబుల్ టు టెస్ట్ ద పీఓసీ వెరీ క్విక్లీ. ద రైట్ రిసోర్సెస్ ఆర్ అవైలబుల్ అండ్ వీ మస్ట్ బి ఏబుల్ టు గివ్ ద డిజైన్ స్పీచ్ ఫాస్టర్ effectively using the tools. So if the tools are not there, you need to, we need to find the process such that we use the tools, otherwise we'll be doing the very simple thing in a long or a complex way. And the technologies, proven and hardened algorithm, future is also in the morning we have been discussing, algorithm is going to be the business. So this is going to be our IT. So proven and hardened algorithm we should create and keep it, then only we can be a competitive, competitive. Uncompromised grams and learn by doing. And one more thing I would like to share is this internet and Google has changed. Two days back I had an experience in our office. I asked Parvati to look into one IC, one of the memory which we want to use it in our future thing, we can adapt. అని కొన్ని చెప్పాను అనమాట. సో దెన్ షీ అలొకేటెడ్ టు సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద జూనియర్, హీ హాస్ వర్క్ ఆన్ ఇట్ అండ్ దే కేమ్ ఫర్ ద రివ్యూ అనమాట. సో ద ఐడియా ఈస్ వెదర్ వీ కెన్ మేక్ యూస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఇన్ టు ద థింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్, బికాస్ ఎర్లియర్ విత్ ఎ స్మాల్ డీటెయిల్ ఐ నో దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ పాసిబుల్ టు యూస్ అనమాట. మన దాంట్లో వీ కెన్ ఇంక్లూడ్ దిస్ అని అనిపించింది. ఐ వాంట్ టు హ్యావ్ అ వెరిఫికేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. బట్ వాట్ హ్యాపన్, దే హ్యావ్ గాన్ ఇన్ టు ద డేటా షీట్. డేటా షీట్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇస్ 300 pages. So they tried to read here and there and they brought it, but without any conclusion. So then I said, no, it's not like that. Just if you use the internet and Google properly, then you can get the result. And in front of him, just with the correct keywords, I got the necessary information within 5 minutes. Why I'm saying this is, morning one more point our CEO was saying, the experience does, I mean, it will not matter now. So what I said 2 days back, internet and Google is keeping on the same plane, you and me. You are so junior here, I may be the senior here, but on the same line. If you use this internet and Google effectively, so we both have a same result we can give. So that chance is having for the millionaires now. So I mean, experience and all is not necessary. With the right way, quickly I was able to get the result, which you would have got it. The same thing I told him, probably. So this is learn by doing. You do not have time to learn. So once you finish your college, then you will not find some separate time for the learning. So learn by doing it, learn by doing it should move faster. So such kind of process one should adapt. So manufacturing also should be agile, tools, flexibility in the manufacturing is required in future. So adopting the technologies and perform everything at the first time. So earlier the process maturity for a time for the, suppose we created something, it takes some time for getting a good deal, But now the challenge of the future processes will challenge to perform first time correctly. So again, the same, they have to be effective with the agile and the tools and technologies. And now with the telepresence, even seniors can visit the site very easily. So the process can be completely relooked into that. So business and support processes should support the all the five stakeholders. So validate the process aligned towards value creation. Okay, you have created a process, it is generating some value, but revisit it, value creation time to time, because technology and paradigm shift happens very, very rapidly. Today you have created a process, so it is not going to be the good process within short time. So if you are really making a good process in our system, that naturally should create a positive cash flow to the organization. So process excellence is improving the way that business created and delivered value to customers. So you have to be ahead than your competitors. So future process is going to be like a fluidic. It's like water. So today you come to office, I'll pour water into glass, today this is the process. Tomorrow I'm going to pour the water into a vessel, this is going to be the process today. The morning one process, evening one process. So it's going to be so fluidic and we must be able to perform. So then only we can be accommodative. Otherwise, so with the technology and with the data, earlier I think Bhavanishinger was saying the Coca-Cola thing, something happens. So it's so fluid. So immediately they rearrange and they correct all the things and they change the process for the business process completely realigned. So such a fluidic nature it is going to be the future. Thank you.